Oh, cool. Just got this little box in the mail from Thonk in England. Let's see what's in here. Something exciting, I'm sure. Okay. Classic little Thonk box. I use a few of these to store components. And what do we have here? It looks like it's the chord organ kit. Very nice. This is actually the same hardware as the Radio Music. This has a different panel and a different firmware, which we can use to play chords. Bag A comes with the components. Bag B comes with the hardware stuff. Headers, sockets, connectors and such. The PCBs. The SD card slot. And the two printed circuit boards go along with the panel to make up this module. And you also get a Music Thing modular button and a sticker. Cool beans. So let's organize the bench and get down to building this thing.
The chord organ is a fairly simple build. As usual, we start with the resistors and diodes. I populated those on both boards at once, then soldered, clipped the leads, checked, and touched up my work. Then on to placing the panel components, pots, jacks, SD card slot, push button, and LEDs. Remember not to solder any of those until after they're secured to the panel, to make sure everything fits. Do not solder the LEDs until after you've secured them at the correct position so they go through the holes on the panel. The button is a bit fiddly. Make sure to orient the flat side how it's drawn on the PCB. Now let's finish the circuit board. I've already populated it with resistors, so now I can add the IC socket, the power diodes, fuses, ferrite bead, capacitors, and the 5-volt regulator. The trim pot and power headers go on the other side, so they face outward when the module is assembled. Time to add some headers to connect both boards together. I pre-cut them to size, then mounted the male headers on the panel PCB facing out. I took the loose female headers and snapped them onto the males, then fit the female header's leads through the holes on the circuit PCB and proceeded to solder them in place. Now the teensy. First I installed the firmware, following the easy instructions on the Music Thing modular page. Then I cut the power trace, so the teensy will get power only from EuroRack, so no accidents happen if I update the firmware with the module plugged into the rack. I also wanted to have the option to remove and replace the teensy if needed, so I made some headers for it too. I liked the idea I saw on the build page of using a protoboard to line up the headers while I solder them onto the teensy. After doing that, I again snapped the loose female headers on the males before fitting them to the circuit PCB and soldering them in place. That's it. Now just snap everything together, check for shorts in the power rails with a meter, stick in an SD card and fire it up. Mine worked perfectly on power up, and I made a patch to test it with the factory cords first.
Here's a little fix that you should do. It's a 100K resistor right there, right between those two leads as you see on the picture. From the IC, three pins over. What this does is it fixes a problem where over time you start losing quality out of the audio output. I left mine on overnight and when I came back to my studio, the sound was really distorted. and restarting the module cleaned it up, but I noticed that it happened again. So I talked to Tom Whitwell, and this is the fix. A 100k ohm resistor right there where you can see.
Now, the Root CV doesn't track 1 volt per octave, which makes chords difficult to control with a normal keyboard. A TKB comes to mind. But I don't have one, so I decided to choose a particular chord progression and write it into the chords list, including the root movements and key changes. That way I only need to modulate the chords parameter to cycle through my entire harmony, and the root control becomes a transposition setting. It took me a bit of scribbling and working out voicings, but I managed to code out the harmony for one of my favorite songs, Fall by Wayne Shorter, a sweet modal piece with a very unique harmony.
Like and subscribe, and consider supporting us on Patreon. See you next time.